Hi everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the characteristics of sound. We will continue with that. Today I am going to discuss about loudness. What do you mean by loudness? When you are scolding, suppose your mother is scolding you. She is asking something and you are replying. You know you are at fault. So you will be telling, no mother, no mummy, I don't want to do like this. So immediately a mother is telling, louder, I can't hear you. So that means loud sound, talk louder. So another example we can discuss. Usually we will say while watching TV, increase the volume. Suppose you are sitting on the sofa and you will be telling your mama, mama, please increase the volume. So what does it mean? When we are increasing the volume of TV, what is actually happening? That means loudness is increasing. When you are increasing the volume of a TV, your loudness is increasing. So loudness is increasing means actually the displacement of the speaker. The displacement of the speaker is increasing. So you know the displacement from its normal position is amplitude. That means you are increasing the amplitude. So your amplitude is increasing. Volume increases. Volume, you are increasing the volume. That means displacement of the speaker is increasing. That means amplitude, you are increasing the amplitude. So you are increasing the amplitude. What is this amplitude? Already we have discussed. That means the amount of sound energy produced is increases. That means you are increasing the amount of sound energy produced. That is actually increases. So what is loudness? Loudness is the measure of sound energy reaching your ear per second. So loudness is the sound energy reaching your ear per second. So this is your loudness. So amplitude is increasing. That means when there is loud sound, you will see this is for loud sound. When sound is faint or feeble, that means your amplitude is very less. It is like this. What is amplitude? This is the maximum distance. This is your amplitude. Here see, you can clearly see here amplitude is less. So this is for a loud sound. And this is for a feeble sound or faint sound. Hope I am clear with the sound, this loudness of your sound. Now, it is clear that this loudness of sound depends on the amplitude. So, loudness of the sound depends on amplitude. How it varies? Very important question for your exam. So, your loudness is directly proportional to amplitude square. Your loudness is directly proportional to amplitude square. That means if you are increasing twice the amplitude, loudness will increase four times. So you are increasing, that means loudness dependent on the amplitude of the vibrating body. And it is directly proportional. Amplitude increases means loudness increases. Another important thing that loudness depends, that factor is distance from the source. that means the distance between the source and the listener, where the sound is getting produced and where the listener is there to listen that sound. How it varies? Loudness is inversely proportional to the distance, again square. Suppose I am screaming, I am calling you. If you are here, you can listen. If you are 1 kilometer far away from me, obviously it is very difficult to hear my sound. So loudness depends on distance, but it is inversely related. That means if distance increases, distance of source and listener, distance between source and listener, if that increases, your loudness will decrease. So this is the second dependency of the loudness. Third important factor, loudness depends on the density of the medium where the sound travels. So when the density increases, when the density of the medium increases, that means your loudness increases. When the density of the medium increases, your loudness also increases. In water, loudness increases comparatively to air. That means your sound, the same loudness sound in water will be louder than your air. Okay? And how you measure this loudness? SI unit is decibel. That is, you write like this. It is measured in decibel. dB. Okay? In physics, your pin drop silence. Pin drop silence. Usually, teacher will be telling the class. Pin drop silence. So, pin drop silence is of 0 dB. In physics, we consider, we know there is no such 0 dB. Still in physics, for so many definitions, for so many comparisons, we consider the ideal situations. So, for pin drop silence, it is 0 dB. That is the faint sound. Okay? And when we are whispering with your friend, that whisper sound is of, this is your pin drop silence. Whisper usually around 30 dB. And normal conversation is around 60 dB. Normal conversation is around, this is normal conversation. Normal conversation is of 60, around 60 dB. It varies from book to book. Okay? And more than 80 dB, more than 80 dB is painful to our ears. So there comes the noise. So more than 80 dB is noise. Painful. More than 80 dB is painful to our ear. More than 80 dB is painful to our ears. Okay? But I want to discuss another important thing, loudness. Suppose you are listening to a song. Maybe it is with a particular volume. Maybe it is like very soothing for you. And maybe it is louder for other person. Maybe it is a noise for another person. If you go to a discotheque, a pub, loud sound will be there. For youngsters, they are enjoying. But if adult is going, oh, so much of noise. That means loudness is not a concrete thing. It differs from person to person. How you perceive, how your ear is perceiving that particular sound. So, loudness is a subjective quantity. It differs from person to person. So, it is a subjective quantity. Okay? So loudness is, what is loudness? It is the sound energy, amount of sound energy or the measure of sound energy reaching your ear per second. But it is a subjective quantity. So how to get the concrete things? So connecting things I am going to discuss, that is intensity. Intensity is a objective quantity. You can measure this. That is no, it will not vary from person to person. So what is this intensity? So intensity is the power of sound. Intensity is the power of sound reaching your ear, but here area will be playing a major role. That means intensity is how much energy pass from unit area in unit time. So what is intensity? Intensity is how much energy pass from unit area in unit time. That is intensity is equal to intensity I. Intensity is equal to energy, how much energy passing from unit area per unit time. So this is your intensity. Intensity is equal to energy passing from unit area per unit time. What is this unit area? Another important thing is there. This unit area should be perpendicular to the direction of the energy. Suppose here speaker is there. It is passing through this particular area. The sound is passing through a particular area. So this is now perpendicular. Okay. So the unit area should be perpendicular to the direction of the energy. This is your direction of energy. The area has to be perpendicular to the direction of the energy. Okay. So you know, you have studied already, what is energy per time? This is energy per time is power. So energy per time is power. That means intensity is the power of sound. Intensity is the power of sound in watts divided by the area, that is in square meters. So intensity is sound, like power, sound power by this unit area. Okay. So you know energy is measured in joule and area is measured in meter square and time in second. Okay. So intensity is measured with joule by meter square into square meter into second. What is this joule per second? This is what you know. Power is measured in what? So this is intensity is measured in watt by meter square. Okay. And 0 dB, that is your pin drop bulb sound, faint sound. So 0 dB is 10 to the power minus 12, 10 to the power minus 12 watt by meter square. So this is your intensity. Hope I am clear on loudness and intensity. Okay. So what is loudness? Loudness is the amount of energy, the amount of sound energy reaching our ear per second. Sometimes in exams or in competitive exams you will get this little twisting questions. So loudness, what is the difference, and intensity. also loudness is sound energy per second. Sound energy reaching your ear per second. And this is sound energy by unit area per unit time. That means sound power per unit area. Okay? And it is measured in dB, it is measured in watt per meter square, all those things are there. But very important is loudness is a subjective quantity, intensity is a objective quantity. So subjective means it will differ from person to person. But intensity is fixed. This much of intense sound is coming. We can't vary that sound. Okay? So intensity is the objective quantity and loudness is a subjective quantity. And this loudness depends on the sensitivity of your ear. But intensity doesn't depend on your sensitivity of the ear. That is there. This much of intensity of sound is coming. So it will not vary as per your sensitiveness of the ear. But loudness varies. For one person it is really loud. For one person it is really soothing voice, soothing music. Maybe for other person it is loud sound, very much loud sound. That person is getting irritated with that noise. So maybe I am getting irritated with that particular sound, but my daughter is enjoying with that sound. So that is your loudness. So loudness depends on your sensitivity of the ear. That's why it is a subjective quantity and it is a objective quantity. Okay? So today we have discussed most important characteristic of sound waves, that is your loudness, and we have also discussed how loudness varies from intensity. Hope I am clear about these characteristics. So tomorrow we are going to discuss about pitch and quality of sound. Thank you.